Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to our second build along. First off, thank you guys so much for tuning in. It has been a blast trying to fix the Pueblo house, and hopefully you guys did see the final results of that. Today's build, as you can see, is the houseboat. It actually was originally supposed to be the cabin for today, the A-frame cabin, but honestly, it was just not going well, you guys. So I kind of changed gears. I did go back to the houseboat. But I do think this lot can definitely use some saving, and we're going to hop into that today for sure. But first off, I hope you guys had a really nice Christmas, holiday break. Whether you did celebrate something or not, I hope you did have a nice time with friends and family, of course. And yeah, the new year is coming up. The new year is coming up so quickly, and I don't know, are you guys ready for it? I feel like it came so quickly. The year is just getting started. I just started my YouTube channel back in July, and now 2023 is at our doorstep. It's just, yeah, it's kind of wild how time flies by. But here we are, we're trying to perhaps make this shell a little bit more interesting. I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with it just yet, but I am going to keep the more modern vibe to this. I'm going to try to add a little bit of detailing there as well. Now, for the colors, I don't really know if I'm going to stick with them, so that's a little bit of a debacle. It's a little bit of a debacle in my head, but I'm thinking that these window lights could be very interesting. For the outside, though, I'm not really sure. I'm going to see if I can try some different things out. Perhaps we can change the railing. The railing is leaving a little bit to be desired, but if we're going super modern, we can probably do something glossy, perhaps. Let's give that a whirl and see what we think. I do believe I like that. This is from the City Living Pack, so maybe we can do something like this. I do love that blue tone. It's not really for everybody, but I think it kind of emulates the ocean well, so perhaps something like this. I could even try and lighten the whole build itself, because it is kind of dark. And for some reason, I chose cement. I don't know, you guys. I think I was trying to go for metal, but, you know, when time is not on your side, you just kind of rush and go through different things. But yeah, I'm thinking something lighter. I'm thinking something lighter like this wood could possibly be viable. So we're going to try that out. I'm going to try to use some of this nice glass railing once more. Just like that. For the roofs, yes, for the roofs, I'm not quite sure what the color is going to be. I do like a little bit of this curvature going on, but yeah, it's a little funky, if I'm being honest with myself. I'm trying to get like a nice wave shape, so perhaps something like this. I think this could be pretty interesting. The deck is also pretty dark, so let's see if we can lighten that up a little bit. And we do have a few options. Now, the problem with this build is I actually used a lot of different packs. I think I used 5, so I'm already over my limit. I think the item that is used that I can probably remove is the Get to Work stuff. Get to Work is... yeah. Get to Work is an interesting pack. Honestly, you guys, I thought that it was a really cool pack, and I used it a lot in my builds. But after a lot of back and forth with the community, I realized that it wasn't as popular as I guess I thought it was. But yeah, I do use it quite a bit. I did use it a lot in some of my older builds. But recently, yeah, not really so much. I feel like I've kind of transitioned. I've used a lot of newer stuff. And yeah, you just have phases like that. You have phases like that in The Sims where, you know, sometimes you're really into a certain kind of gameplay, sometimes you're not. You kind of shift between packs, or, you know, if you're bad, you kind of get a new pack and you kind of leave the other ones behind a little bit. I do believe I do that with building, at least. But, you know, do what you do. Do you, have fun, and enjoy the game. But yes, we're trying to clean this up a little bit. I'm probably going to redo the inside because it also is pretty dark. Again, I'm not really sure what I was thinking with the inside. It's kind of... Yeah, it's very cement. I feel like I was going for sort of an industrial look, but it didn't really work out. It didn't really flesh out the way it should have. So I think for now, I'm just going to go with this light wood throughout. I do think we need something else on the inside because I can't really use the same wood everywhere. Perhaps for the decking, we can find something different. Because we do have some different island living stuff here. So maybe like a more faded wood for the boardwalk portion. So maybe something like this. But it just doesn't really go with anything. So maybe this older wood could do. Yeah, I think that works. The part I'm not really sure about is the bottom, you guys. There probably is a better way to make a houseboat. I've seen people use the debug boat, but obviously when I was doing this, I didn't really have a lot of time, so I just kind of went with, I guess, the first thing that came to mind. I pretty much figured I could do a larger platform like this and just kind of roll with it. But I think the way we can fix that is we can actually pull the lot back so it won't look so awkward, I guess, because the bottom of the ship is so large. Let me see if I can pull it back a little bit more, kind of looking like maybe it's docked. I'm not sure. Maybe I'll actually just leave it the way it is. I think that's not bad. But perhaps I can cover it a little bit with some of the debug objects. Oh no. I didn't put the cheat in, you guys. I am so unprepared for this. But yeah, let me see if I can add that in really quickly. I do BB show hidden objects, if my memory doesn't fail me. BB show live edit objects on. What? It's not letting me do it, you guys. Let me see. Ah, here we go. Perfect. Debug is finicky. Debug is a very finicky feature, you guys. I'm sure a lot of you have used it before, but yeah, it's a little bit of a pain sometimes. I do think it worked. I think. And part of me says it did not. Yeah. Let's see. Let's even get it to work. I feel like I'm missing something. Show live edit objects on. Why is this not working, you guys? This is a bad time for this. Testing cheats on. And we'll do BB show live edit objects. I feel like my memory is failing me right now. Ah, I think we got it. Anyways, like I was saying, debug is a very finicky feature. I absolutely love a lot of the objects that came with it. But as you guys know, it's a little hard locating objects in the game. Some of them are searchable, some of them are not, so it's kind of a hit or miss situation. But I'm thinking I can just add a little bit of terraforming on the outside. I'm kind of disguising the bottom of the ship, you know? I'm kind of cheating, you guys, but, you know, do what you do to make the lot work. I actually really enjoy using these debug objects. A lot of them are very interesting. They add a lot of realism to your build. But the thing that's a pain, especially if you're using a lot of the larger mountain features, is they are not really, what's the best word I can say? The best way I can describe it is they don't have actual mass in game. So a lot of times your Sims will just kind of go through the rocks, and it can be quite cumbersome. It's cumbersome if you're trying to do gameplay and you're trying to kind of maneuver around certain things. So yeah, it's a little bit of an issue. But yeah, anyways, I'm just trying to kind of block the boat in. I want to take away from the distraction of the large bottom portion, so there is that. But I do think we can add a little bit of landscaping as well. So let's exit out of Island Living. We can get a little bit of a... I'm not really sure what kind of path would lead up to this. I can add a little bit of rock just to soften the area a little bit. Just turn down that brush and just gently paint in a little bit right here, kind of at our entry point. And I do know that I want, a little bit of, plant life in this build. Now it's gonna be a little tricky because I have to remember which packs are used in here. I know that we have Snowy Escape, we have get to work. I think we have get together in here, so it's quite a bit, but I think we can figure out what we can use. So for trees, I'm so inclined to use the island living. I really love these palm trees, but I think I'll go safe and just use the ones that came with island living, because they are some really nice options. And I really enjoy this hanging palm tree variant. So I think I'll stick one right here. I'll kind of build up around the entrance area just to make it a little bit more inviting. Probably something like this. Maybe a few more over here, I think. So something like that. These palm trees are just ready to be used with hammocks, I can tell. I don't know if you guys have ever laid in a hammock, but they're kind of a mixed experience. I know that my mom used to love them and we used to put them in our lanai, but some of them are very uncomfortable. I believe like that traditional, like woven hammock with the holes in it is kind of uncomfortable sometimes. Sometimes you're trying to get positioned and you end up falling through the holes. You have like a toe or a foot or a hand coming through. It's a very uncomfortable experience. But my mom did have one that was like a full canvas material, so it was a lot more supportive. And it was fairly comfortable. You feel like you're almost in a little cocoon. So that's kind of a weird experience, but yeah, I think I can see why some people enjoy it. But like I said, I'm trying to add a little bit of foliage just to make this area of the lot a little bit more inviting, because the beach was pretty barren. I think when I originally did this, I just completely ran out of time. So pretty much all of the yard, all of the front entrance was pretty empty. Now, it's unfortunate because I am inclined to use some of the Jungle Adventure stuff, but I'm gonna hold back. I do wanna keep this pack limited, so I think I'll try to find some other stuff. I do like some of these plants from the Island Living pack, so perhaps some of these nice red flowers. Just again, going with the... Woo! Okay, again, going with the landscaping here, trying to stay close to the rest of the foliage. So I do think this is quite nice. I do think we can include possibly some lamps. I'm thinking we can do the torches from this pack as well. Let's see. I'm going to go to the nighttime view just to take a look. We do have these, which are pretty cool, but I'm not sure if they're going to go with the outside, or rather, I'm not sure if they're going to go with the look of the houseboat itself. So I think I will try using these torches first just to see how they work. Oh my goodness, the camera's going berserk, you guys. But yeah, let me see how I like these here. Now, if you guys know, there is a debug feature. There is like a little mound of sand, and I'm going to try and find it. If you guys know me, I do like keeping builds fairly realistic. And if there are things like this, if there are torches in the ground, there would normally be some kind of little mound around it trying to show that it pretty much went through the soil. So I'm going to try and locate that item. But yeah, debug is difficult. Debug is very unorganized, as you can see. I'm just going through and I just see a bunch of fish. And I think I found the sand. Yes, this is perfect. All right. Now again, my mouse is not cooperating the way it should, you guys, but hopefully you can bear with me a little bit. I'm gonna try to use my trackpad. But yes, we do have the mounds of sand, so this feels more in tune with the world. And I do think this is a pretty nice little entrance, if I do say so myself. I would do probably a little archway there, but yeah, I'm not really sure if this build needs it. I'm gonna go in and check out some of the windows. The windows are a feature that I'm really not sure about. This is a little tricky. I have a ladder going through a window. That's not cool. that is not good, you guys. That is not very realistic. But let's see if we can find a better place to put it. I know that this deck was a little bit tight, so this could be a little tricky. What I could do is actually substitute for some smaller windows, but it will be a little bit of a bother on the first floor. So yeah, I'm not quite sure what we're gonna do. I could do it coming up here, but then we'll have to move the counter. That makes sense. So we can probably try moving the bed just to see. Uh-oh. We have mismatching wood here. Let me see. These curved walls, you guys, they don't even... Look at that, you guys. This is glitching out. I'm trying to get it in the right direction, but the game is just not allowing it. So I think that will do. I think that blends enough. This is definitely a bug that the Sims team needs to fix. Because you can see the indentations where the corners are, so that's always bothersome. But unfortunately, as players, I don't really think there is a true workaround for that. So yeah, it's a little frustrating, I'm not gonna lie, but I think we can get around it a little bit. But anyways, let's see if we can move this. When I was building this, this was intended to be a control room of sorts. But yeah, I wasn't really too keen on how houseboats functioned. But we're going to try and keep that control room there in some shape or form, I guess. But I'm thinking that the ladder can go here instead. I think it's going to be a little bit more beneficial to us to have it in the corner. Perhaps? I feel like every way I go, the ladders themselves interrupt the mirrors. Not mirrors, I'm sorry. It's interrupting the windows, so that's kind of a bother. I'm really not sure how I can get around that. Yeah, that's really tricky, you guys. Because I can move it. I can get rid of a window, but it's going to be a little dark in here. I can go like this. And have one window, but again, it's pretty sad, it's pretty barren. So maybe we can figure out something. I could have it go in the middle, but then we have no door. Yeah. Okay, this is gonna be hard, you guys, because we can move back there, but alas, I'm not sure. Not really sure, you guys. Okay, so it's gonna be the lesser of all the evils here. We have this one in the corner, we have this one on the side. If I do it in the corner, we don't touch the windows, but we're just not gonna have a window over here, which I think is problematic because we are in the front of the ship. We do want a nice view, so I guess perhaps the ladder has to go in this corner. I guess that's going to have to be the best option. And then I'll just have to figure out something else for the windows. I'm thinking I can delete these. Maybe a smaller window, so a window that doesn't go full length, but can definitely have a nice enough view, hopefully. Okay, so for this build, I'm still sticking with the very modern look, so I'm going to try to emulate that the best I can. I can go for something like this, perhaps, and just have it like this. I think it matches the other windows. So maybe this, I'm going to try and apply it here, a little bit higher up. And I'm honestly not sure if we're going to keep Snowy Escape. That was one of the original packs that was used in this build, but yeah, I'm going to try to keep it a little bit more limited. I'm going to close in this area just a tad. And I think I can go with the regular... Oh, this is actually not bad. We can actually use the island living windows because we can get a pretty nice view like this. I think if we're living in a houseboat, we do want quite a view. So maybe that many windows is not bad. Yeah, I'm actually not minding that. I think the problem is the other side is going to be very lopsided because we do have the full kitchen, but the kitchen can't have giant windows like this. So this is going to be a little bit tricky. I can try to cram the kitchen. I can try to cram the kitchen into a smaller space. We do have this decently sized bathroom here. But I think that's going to have to be moved around just a little bit. So I think what I'm going to do, you guys, I'm actually going to move some of this stuff out. I'm going to move it out Yeah, I don't know what I'm keeping just yet. I think that fridge is going to go, but we can reconfigure this bottom floor. Yeah, because I do want windows on both sides. I think that's really nice. The whole point of being in a houseboat is to have a gorgeous view. At least that's what I would think. For me, I've never been on a houseboat. I've never been on a yacht or anything like that. The closest thing I can think of is probably just like a cruise I've been on, trying to simulate that, you know, on the ocean experience, which is pretty close. But again, it's the cruise ship is quite large. It's quite large. It's quite noisy and chaotic. It's fun, but it's definitely a lot different than living on a houseboat. But yeah, I think we can figure out a different solution for this area. I'm going to try and pull this bathroom in a little bit because I do think we can actually get it to function with the 4x4. The kitchen, on the other hand, that's going to be a little bit more difficult. But perhaps we can try to make it work. I think we can actually do another window here and have maybe... okay, it's going to be a little weird, you guys. But I think we can do the fridge along the wall. So I'm going to start pulling things back in. We do have the bed here. Snowy escape, again, I'm not quite sure if we're going to use it. But we can do a modern fridge for now. So something like this. And I do like these countertops as well. Maybe not in this color. It's a little dark, but potentially it could work. So yeah, I'm thinking something like this. I'm going to delete the fridge for now. Bye-bye to the bed. We're going to figure out this arrangement. So we can't exactly have counters going through the window, but I think I can actually float them. I can actually float them a little bit farther away, and I think this can be a really good solution for us. So we do have a fridge here. We do have the full counters, and yeah, I think that's working, you guys. I'm going to pull it out just a little tiny bit. Again, I don't think you would have this arrangement in real life, but, you know, sometimes there's some weird, you know, architectural anomalies in the world. Sometimes, I don't know if you guys have found articles like this, but sometimes there are really funny articles featuring houses from Zillow. Zillow is pretty much an online listing platform for real estate, and there are some weird houses out there, you guys. I think I've seen some pretty weird stuff. I've seen like a toilet in the middle of the stairs. Like, I don't know who's gonna use it like that. That was a very, very poor choice in terms of where to place a toilet. But if you guys look them up, you'll definitely know what I mean. There are some very bizarre things out there. So I don't think that this arrangement is too odd. Like I said, again, I'm not sure if I'm keeping Snowy Escape, but I do know I want the interior a little bit lighter from what I had it before. So we can try doing a sort of cream color. Maybe it might be a little too cream. But I don't actually mind it. I do think this is looking a lot better so far. So I'm generally pretty happy with how this is looking. I like the sunroof. There is a little bit of this area with the bathroom, but I think that's fine. I don't think it's too bothersome. But yeah, we're going to figure out a color scheme for the inside because that is definitely the trickier part of things. If we do keep this stove, we can actually do it in a black. We can do it like this, which is not too bad. I don't know if it's a little bit... I don't know if it's a little bit too bland, like if there's not enough contrast, but perhaps if we can get some color in, I think that could really spruce things up. Again, that does ultimately depend on what I'm using. I may opt for the City Living Pack because we do have a lot of cool stuff in there. The other thing that's on the table is actually the, what is this pack called? I totally forgot. This pack, the Tiny Living stuff, yes. This is potentially on the table. We do have a lot of cool stuff in here. So if I can make a vibe for you guys, if I can make it work, I think that could be a possibility. Because I do like this rug. I do think it fits the build itself. If we can get something going on here. Again, for color schemes, I'm not quite sure. But yeah, we're definitely gonna check it out. I do like this blue. I think the blue and the cream go together really well. So let me actually look into what is a part of the... Oh my goodness, I'm forgetting the name, you guys. Let me see what is in the Tiny Living pack, because we do have a lot of really cool stuff. So I'm going to go here and put show all, and okay, we do have really interesting things. I do enjoy this hanging plant. This hanging plant, is it a sculpture? Is it a... Yeah, I'm not really sure. Is it a sculpture? Is it hanging succulents? Whatever it is, I do think it's quite fun. So I do want something like this. We can go brown. We can match the blue tones a little bit. I think that's very interesting. I don't think this will be an off-grid build, so I'm not really going to go that extreme. I do enjoy this little tea set. I think this is very interesting. But it does look like it's more for... It looks more like a item for the living room. We can include this. This is interesting, but I think that's for the bathroom. Obviously, you can tell that I've used this pack so much. I'm just all over the place. But I do enjoy this. I think we need a little bit of some cozy details that kind of fit the vibe itself. The black is actually quite fitting. I do enjoy that. But because this space is a little small, I think what we will need to do is we will need to keep the bedroom on the first floor, because we could put it up here, but it's going to be a little weird if the bedroom is also the control room. I'm not really sure how I feel about that. What I might do is actually make this space into an office, and that should kind of mold the two a little better. But yeah, I do like the feel of how this is coming along. Let me bring back the bed. They do have this bed from the Tiny Living pack also, which I think is pretty neat. But yeah, I think we could even tuck it away in here. I think that's not bad. A little bit more privacy. And it is on the smaller side, so I do enjoy that. It can definitely fit very easily in there. But color scheme is difficult. I do like this blue, but it kind of breaks from everything. There's a lot of tan options, surprisingly. But if we don't find something we like, we can also try a different bed as well. But this one is working a little bit. It's giving me a little bit of Greek. I feel very Greek and Mediterranean with these colors. So not bad. It's not a bad flavor, you guys. We might roll with it, but I'm just going to try to look and see if there is something better. We do have this one from base game. There's this one, but I'm not really sure if I want to go with it. I think because we just kind of see it all the time. But it's not a bad option. You guys might have to let me know. Not really sure. I think I'm going to try to use the Tiny Living one. I think this one does work better. So I'm thinking, let's see. We can go white with orange. That doesn't quite go. Oh, these swatches are something, you guys. But I think we'll go with this option. And I think we're going to have fun with this. We're going to try to use a lot more of the Tiny Living stuff, because I don't think I've used it just yet in these builds. So I think we can feature more of these items. Let me see if there is anything else. So we do have this. This is from the City Living pack. And I do think that's pretty sleek. It's very fitting. So I will include that. And there is a Tiny Living painting that I do enjoy. And it's the only one, you guys. but I think we can have some really interesting motifs. I do know that there is a tropical leaf in here somewhere. Oh, there we go. We do have some tropical leaves, and I do think that would be really fun with this build. It definitely speaks to more of the island living life, some of the natural flora, the natural foliage in this area. I'm going to try to do something quirky and... You know, bear with me, you guys. I don't know if it's going to work, but perhaps I can do a small collage. I think this could be a little interesting piece here. and it may be the only one because we don't have a lot of wall space. A lot of the walls are in fact windows, but perhaps something like this. I think this could be an interesting detail, just having a lot of different objects there. And if we need more plants, we can also put them here. I'm thinking we can also do some curtains up there. Oh my goodness. Going rogue again. Anyways, we can do some curtains up there to try and put a little bit of shade. But yeah, I'm not sure if we're going to have any good options. We can do these larger shades here. I can make them a little bit smaller and just kind of go across like this. Yeah. It's a little funky. It's a little funky, you guys. So let me try it with the larger size. Oh, goodness. Snapping. Snapping is just not my friend today. Yeah. That's not working. Okay. That's okay. Let me see if we have other options. And if not, I think that's okay. We can still have a really great view. There are these, which I do enjoy. And these probably feel a little bit more realistic. They feel more like blinds that you would regularly have. So we could do something like this. Have some blinds going around. We could try them in white. It's a little bit of a thinker. I don't know if I enjoy them, you guys. I think they're a little, dare I say, ugly. I don't think they quite work. There's also these. I think they could also fit the island vibe. They do look like they're made out of bamboo. So this could be an option. But if not, I can also try something else. I think I'll try leaving two of them open and then having two on the sides just like that. I think that's not bad. And I do want to add in a little plant. I do think we need a little bit more plant life in this little houseboat because it is pretty barren. I'm going to see if we have anything from, let's see, if we have Island Living. I think this is like one of the only plants, which is a little limited. I do enjoy this one, so this is not a bad option. Yeah, let's take a look. We do have this one. Pretty interesting option, but it's huge, and I think the colors are limited. I think this small one might be the one we're going to go with. So let me do this. Just kind of bump it up. It doesn't snap to the counters, unfortunately, but we can have something like this here. And I don't really mind that. It's clipping a little bit. Let me see if I can actually situate it. Yeah, there we go. So we have a little plant there, and I'll change color to maybe something a little bit lighter. Let's see. Maybe a little bit of blue. And yeah, I don't really mind that, you guys. I think that's looking a lot better. And, you know, crazy mouse, malfunctioning mouse aside, I do think this is looking a lot better. I'm enjoying the inside. I do think the outside is looking better. And, oh my goodness, we're gonna get rid of that. But yeah, anyways, I do think this is quite a good start so far. We do have a lot more landscaping. We did give the outside a little bit of an overhaul. But like I said, I think this is a pretty good stopping point, and we will definitely continue going with this in the next installment. So hopefully you guys did enjoy watching. I do hope you guys enjoy how this is developing, and I'll certainly see you guys in the next installment of the houseboat renovation. And as always, this has been TownieSimBuilds signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.